的神，我的王，我的心要依靠你，凡投靠你，你必不惧怕，等候你的必不羞愧。
愿你崇高，
愿你的崇高过于诸天，你的荣耀高过全地，你统管万有，你治理列邦，万国万民都敬拜你，你是那独行信实的神，主耶和华，我的神，我的王，我的心要依靠你，
主，我要来投靠你，
凡投靠你的必不惧怕，等候你，
主啊，让台湾来等候你，来投靠你，愿你崇高，
愿你的崇高过于诸天，你的荣耀高过全地，你统管万有，你治理列邦，万国万民都敬拜你。
主啊，愿你崇高，
愿你崇高过于诸天，你的荣耀高过全地。
耶和华的军队一起来宣告，愿神崇高过于诸天，
万国万民都敬拜你。
Thank you. 稣在台湾已经掌权了，主耶稣基督在台湾掌权了。
感谢神，我们在见证也在参与台湾的转化跟复兴，所以请你跟你旁边人说，你是历史的见证人，
见证人。
从11月的第一周开始，我们从台南直到今天最后一天的晚上，我们相信这不是一个结束，是好多兴奋的事在我们的里面。从第一天11月第一周开始到现在，我没有漏掉任何一场聚会。在很多的地方，我真的是见证神在我们台湾所做的一切的事。特别的一件事情是，每一次任何一个城市，台南、高雄、新竹、台北聚会，都不是当城市的人，当地城市的牧者跟弟兄姊妹，而是许多连结，我们结盟在一起的牧者跟同工一起在一起。让台南的聚会是花莲、嘉义、彰化都来到一起。在花莲台南的聚会之前，花莲的牧者们就来了20多位，先住在台南，在聚会前2天，然后他们20多人就先绕行整个的台南，祝福台南。然后在台南的整个突破的过程当中，我们一起哭，我们一起宣告，我们一起看见那个城市进入到神的那个立约的位置里面，那一种的感情，那一种同哭同求同看到这块土地你跟我彼此之间的那个重要，那一种氛围在整个城市当中，在整个国家当中已经发生在我们中间。我们发现在这一次的4个礼拜当中，我们已经不再分彼此。更重要的是，这一次台湾我们17个把县市加在一起算一个单位，有16个县市我们都已经与神立约了。我们不再是一个孤单孤立一个独自在奋斗的一个国家，我们乃是与神立约的国。我记得礼拜五早上，约翰牧师在跟牧者们的聚集里面，他说他只是一个传递信息的人。最重要的是，台湾的弟兄姊妹跟守城门的，我们怎么看待这个信息？他告诉我们说，我们从台湾这么多年来的历史里，我们看到这个时刻，神在过去里面放上多少复兴祷告的砖头，一块一块一块一块的叠到现在。他看到台湾在全世界列国最宝贵的一个见证，就是父老弟兄姊妹和教会的合一。这些砖头叠着，让我们中生代的牧者继续的往前踩在他们的基业上面，他们到如今仍旧跟我们同心站立。台湾最宝贵的就是我们的父老群在这里遮盖我们，让我们往前跑，让我们往前追随过去的脚步，踩在他们的基业上面继续往前去。我真的很感谢主，也非常非常从里面激动。我们今天来了好几块砖头，是过去到现在我们踩在他们身上。如果要找到祷告运动，你就不能够不提到张茂松牧师。欢迎张茂松牧师，我们拍手欢迎，也感到非常的荣幸，他跟我们站立在一起。我们真的看见过去这么多年，他说他要做春泥，他说他要把自己生命化为乌有，让更多的在他身上长出来。这是一个伟大的砖头。我们也看到过去在圣灵运动过程当中，如果不是有人一直顶着那个圣灵的工作，带来圣灵正确的教导，我们也不可能有今天这个台湾自由的敬拜和圣灵的工作。我们感谢朱子生牧师，拍拍手，谢谢另外一个砖头。我们跟你旁边人说，你也是一块砖头，小砖头。感谢神，我们在这个总统府的前面，东门城的门口，这是一个立约的城，这是一个立约的国。我们不是在将我们的命运交给这世上任何一个政权，乃是我们欢迎主执掌王权，直到永永远远。我相信这是一个非常神圣的一刻。你记不记得，我不知道你得救多久，在这块土地上，我们什么时候，我们的国家所有的弟兄姊妹教会我们联合在一起， 与神立约。今天我们不止在这里聚集，我们还有在全国23个据点同时开放，并且我们在前面已经有12个城市与主一同立约。我里面非常感动的一件事情，我跟我们祷告网络的理事长周神柱牧师，他是一个非常重要的父老，也是一块大石头。我跟他说，牧师啊，好不好你今天带着我们把我们的国家交在主的手中好吗？让我们的国家与神立约好吗？我们成为一个有约的国，那不乳养的、不生养的要怀孕生养，那羞辱的要抬起头来。在耶和华命定的禧年，我们要宣告一切的自由，新的门，那个新的循环的门，在这个门口，这些历史的门，这些古老的门户，不管多少的历史背景，多少的仇恨，多少的所有的邪灵的控制，在中华民国100年的禧年，中华民国台湾，我们要进入神命定的永约，我们要成为一个立约的国。亚伯拉罕、以撒、亚瑟的神就是与我们立约的神，因着这个约我们能够往前去，因着这个约我们的征战成为他的征战，因着这个约他的公义成为我们的公义，因着这个约他的名字成为我们的新的名字，因着这个约他的产业成为我们的产业，因着这个名字他所有一切的恩宠都要临到我们中间。弟兄姊妹，这一刻我们一同起立好吗？周牧师，请张牧师上来好吧，我们请所有的牧者们，我们一同起立到台上来。我们不是为了名分，我们也不是为了什么，是一个传递信息的人来告诉我们，这是我们自己决定的时刻。牧者们请到台上来。你有没有想过，我们踏的这块土地几百年来一直搞不清楚他到底是谁，谁都说不清楚我们的命运。有人说我们是这个，有人是说我们是那个。今天全台湾的教会，我们站在一起，我们同心合一的站在一起。主啊，愿那我们在禧年即将结束的时刻，我们帮这个国家奉献给你，我们做我们的，你做你的主。
这个时刻，我们心里面存的感恩也是非常的激动。我们算什么？我们台湾算什么？但是神竟验中我们，我们只有在神面前说，神啊，求你恩待怜悯我们，让我们能够跟上你的心意。我们何等的期待我们能够成为神君尊的祭司，能够在这里看见有一个圣洁的国度，看见这里有一群属神的子民。我们愿意说，主啊，你的心意能够成就，你的国能够降临在我们中间。在这一次4个城市各个地方，每一个地其他的附近的城市也一次聚集， 都有一起，众牧者众弟兄姊妹在神面前立约。我想这个时候我也把这样的立约，我们在这里代表国家的一个城门，也是代表整个执政掌权在这里的地方，我们愿意再一次来到神面前，我们愿意说这个国家要跟你立约，要成为你立约的国度。我们在这里，我们代表在台湾的各城市，各城市的牧者，我们在这里，我们也以在这里有今天现在20几个一同转播的每一位，每一个城市，每一个弟兄姊妹，我们在这里，我们愿在这里，我们一起同心合一的站立，在台湾这个关键的时刻，愿意尽心尽意完成神对我们国家对我们城市的命定。我们要竭力带领神的百姓寻求神，依靠主耶稣大能大力，刚强的为城市为国家站立，并在教会和城市中兴起合一的祭坛，服侍神在这个时代对我们城市我们国家的心意，持守属神的标准，不向世俗妥协，脱离一切的败坏的风俗，所有抵挡神的作为。我们欢迎父神一切复兴转换的工作临到我们中间，我们邀请圣灵来造访我们的国家城市，愿台湾众城市一同站立，悔改这土地的一切黑暗权势，竭尽心力带领神的百姓，我们的子祖孙孙，我们的世世代代进入神对台湾的永约，承受神命定给我们的基业。我们如此站立同心立约，奉主耶稣基督的名，阿们阿们阿们。
上帝，我弟兄姐妹，我们经常站立在这里，今天能不能让我们跪在总统府的前边，为这块土地来祷告？主，我们恭敬把这块土地交在主你的手上。上帝，谢谢你把这么美丽的一块土地给我们，谢谢你让台湾它是我们的家，谢谢你，这是我们生长的地方，这是我们生根立命的所在。你用这块土地培育了我们，你用这块土地富裕了我们，养成了我们。上帝，我们谢谢你，我们谢谢你，我们赞美你，我们赞美你，我们赞美你。这国家像你从火里头抽出来的一根柴，上帝，你真是把我们从火里头抽出来的一根柴。60年前这国家就应当已经不存在了，但是我们谢谢你让我们留到现在，我们谢谢你让我们留到现在，谢谢你留下一块干净的净土给我们。上帝，要我们在你面前祝福，我们愿你的心意成就，我们愿你的旨意行在地上，如同行在天上。 我们祝福这块土地，我们祝福，上帝不允许人撕裂，不允许仇恨在这里散播，不允许罪恶在这里滋长。上帝，我们仰望你，我们仰望你。这个国家不是属于黑暗权势的，这国家不是属于偶像权势的，这国家不是属于仇恨的，这国家是属于你的爱的，在你的爱里头的，在你的盼望中间的。上帝，不论谁咒诅这个国家，但主我们说我们爱这个国家。上帝，我们跪在你面前为这块土地祷告，让这块土地成为最荣耀的土地，让这块土地成为最恩典的土地。上帝，我们为这些百姓祷告，让这些百姓是最善良的百姓，这些百姓是认识耶和华的百姓。上帝，我们祝福，我们祝福这国家变成一个荣耀的国家，要变成一个让我们抬起头来的国家。上帝，我们祝福这个土地要变成全世界最美丽的地方，全世界百姓最羡慕的地方。我们要祝福这块土地要成为全世界的祝福，要变成全世界的祝福。上帝，我们谢谢你，我们赞美你，我们向你立约。谢谢你用你的用你儿子的生命跟我们立约，今天我们向你立约，要用我们的生命爱这块土地，用我们的连日祝福这块土地，用我们的努力祝福这块土地。你这样祝福他，上帝让我们就这样祝福他。我们谢谢你，我们赞美你，我们赞美你，奉耶稣的名祷告。阿
门，阿门，阿门。跟你旁边的人说，我们是立约的国，与神立约的国。
我们是立约的国，与神立约的国。
我们一起拍手欢迎我们的讲员。我们最重要，神差来的那一位向我们说话的使徒，穆约翰牧师跟曾前芬牧师，拍手欢迎他们。
Hallelujah.
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 I greet you all in the wonderful name of our Lord Jesus.
奉我们主耶稣基督奇妙美好的名来问候各位。
What God is doing in our midst may not be fully understandable to us.
神在我们当中所做的，或许我们不全明白。
But it's definitely, definitely going to affect the nation.
但诚然会影响整个国家。
And what has just been done a few minutes ago by the pastors?
几分钟前，经由牧者们所做成的这件事。
Done here on these grounds at this gate.
在这片土地上，在这个城门口所做成的事。
Is an act of spiritual authority that is at governmental level.
这是一个带着属灵权柄进入到治理层次的一个行动。
You could record this somewhere in your diary.
所以你可以在你的日记上记下这一刻。
And mark it as a day that the first dedication on these grounds before this very, very authoritative ground was made.
所以记下来这一天，就是我们带着权柄把这片土地献给神的日子。
Because you look back several years later and see what the Lord will have done, and you will remember that.
因为几年之后，当我们回顾神借着今天的行动所成就的，你就会明白了。
Amen.
Amen.
Now let us take a moment to make your neighbor relax around you.
现在让我们用点时间，也让旁边的弟兄姊妹呢都觉得很放松、很轻松。
Turn around, look straight in the eyes of your neighbor, and give them your best smile.
所以转向旁边的人，给他你最美的笑容。
Then bless them in Jesus' name.
奉耶稣的名来祝福他们。
Tell them relax, the Lord is here.
告诉他们说放轻松，我们的主就在这里。
You know.There are so many different Christian gatherings.
有很多不同基督徒的聚集。
Some gatherings are crusades.
有些呢是布道会。
Some gatherings are healing gatherings.
有些是医治特会。
Some are for deliverance.
有些是赶鬼的聚会。
Some are for teaching and expounding on God's word.
有些呢就是在教导跟阐释神的真理的聚会。
I just want all of us to be aware what kind of gathering we are in right now.
但是如今我要各位明白，我们这个聚集是属于哪一种聚集？
This is an awakening gathering.
这是一个苏醒的聚集。
And the fruit of an awakening gathering is supposed to stir and release something in our hearts.
苏醒的聚集，它的目的就是要搅动我们的心，从我们的心中能够释放一些东西出来。
It is supposed to bring us to respond to a call upon our lives.
就是要我们能够起来回应在我们生命中的呼召。
And it's supposed to stir a passion in our hearts.
而且要来搅动我们里面的热情。
So it's important to be aware of what the Holy Spirit is doing.
因此要能够敏锐地察觉圣灵在动的功。
And to be willing to walk with Him, to respond with Him, that He takes us where we need to go.
并且愿意来回应他，与他同行，让他带领我们到我们需要去的地方。
Amen.
Amen.
So let me invite you to go to the book of Joel.
现在让我们一起来看约珥书。
To the scripture that we started with yesterday.
是我们昨天开始的时候读的经文。
Chapter 3 from verse 9 to verse 14.
约珥书第三章从九节到十四节。
Let us read together. Everybody participate. Raise your voice and let us read together.
让我们大家都每一个人都开口同声来读。当在万民中宣告说，要预备打仗，激动勇士，使一切战士上前来，要将犁头打成刀剑，将镰刀打成戈矛，软弱的要说，我有勇力，四围的列国啊，你们要速速的来，一同聚集，耶和华，求你使你的大能者降临，万民都当兴起上到约沙法谷，因为我必坐在那里审判四围的列国。开镰吧，因为庄稼熟了，践踏吧，因为酒榨满了，酒池盈溢，他们的罪恶甚大，许多许多的人在断定谷，因为耶和华的日子临近断定谷。
Amen. Let us pray.
让我们祷告。
Father, in the name that's above every name,
父啊，奉那超越一切之名以上的名，
the name of your dear Son Jesus Christ,
也就是你所爱的儿子耶稣基督的名，
we are gathered together on this very important ground in Taipei.
今天我们聚集在台北这一片非常重要的土地上，
and we join with our brothers who are in all the other cities around Taiwan.
我们也跟台湾其他城市的这些弟兄姊妹们同心。
Lord, we realize that this is a Kairos moment.
主，我们明白这是一个关键的时刻。
We realize that in the spirit there are gates that are opening.
我们明白在灵界里有一些门户已经被打开了。
And that you are calling this nation to rise to a higher ground.
你正在呼召这个国家进入到至高之处。
Therefore, we pray to you today.
因此今天我们向你祷告。
As you have gathered us together.
如同你今日聚集我们在一起。
Lord, speak to us by the power of your word.
主啊，通过你的话语的全能对我们说话。
And by your Holy Spirit, give us wisdom, revelation, and understanding.
借着你的圣灵，求你使我们得着智慧、启示跟明白的心。
Father, we pray for grace.
父啊，我们向你祈求恩典。
To apply what we are learning.
能够将我们所学习的运用出来。
We also pray for our leaders.
我们也为我们的领袖们祷告。
Church leaders and spiritual leaders all across this nation.
在这个国家里面所有教会跟属灵的领袖们。
That the grace and anointing of God shall come upon them, Lord.
愿神的恩惠跟恩膏能够临到他们身上。
In a new and fresh way.
用新的更新的方式来临到他们。
Take lead and go and take this nation where it needs to go.
让他们能够带领这个国家进入到他当去的地方。
Oh God.
Oh, 神啊。
Let your will be done.
愿你的旨意成全。
And this we ask in Jesus' name.
我们这样祈求是奉耶稣的名。Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I want to begin by sharing some testimony with you.
所以一开始我想要跟各位分享一些见证。
And then I'll go on to apply the principles that are in that testimony.
然后再来运用就是这些见证里面的一些法则。
In Uganda.
在乌干达。
I was very busy with my ministry.
我在事工上是很忙碌的。
I was trying my best to serve the Lord according to His calling on my life.
我总是按照神在我生命中的呼召竭心尽力。
And I was focusing on what I know He called me to do.
然后我的焦点就是放在他呼召我要去做的工上。
And then we began to get some problems in the ministry.
但是我们的事工开始出现一些问题了。
Some misunderstandings with the leadership team.
跟我们的领导团队有一些误解发生。
Some misrepresentations amongst us.
在我们当中呢，也有一些人的行为呢是没有办法代表我们的。
Every effort we made to try and solve them was just not working.
但是我们努力要去解决这些问题的方式呢，都行不通。
And suddenly it dawned upon me.
突然间呢，我里面好像有一个亮光。
That the enemy is.Working hard to break up the ministry.
原来仇敌是仇敌努力要来分裂我们这个事工。
And that if we did not fight, we are going to see the ministry broken up, and we are going to scatter.
如果我们不起来征战的话，我们就会看到这个事工被毁了，然后我们就四散了。
I love the ministry so much.
我非常热爱事工。
I was willing to do anything.
所以我愿意付上一切代价。
So I asked the Lord, "What can I do? Just..." Tell me anything, I will pay any cost to save this work.
因此我就问神说，主啊，告诉我，我该怎么做？我愿意付上一切代价来服侍你。
And the Lord led me to go into a fast on water only for 30 days.
所以主呢，就带领我做一个30天只喝水的禁食。
And I started the fast.
所以我就开始这样的禁食。
And as soon as the fast started, He began to open my eyes to see things that I had not seen before.
那当禁食一开始，神就开启我的眼目，让我看见一些以前我没看见的事。
He showed me my mistakes.
他让我知道我的错在哪里。
He showed me my misunderstanding with the others.
他也让我明白我是怎么误会了其他人。
Then he showed me the mistakes that others were doing.
以及让我知道其他人所犯的错在哪里。
The miscommunications.
以及我们之间不良的沟通。
And then slowly he brought me to a place of brokenness and repentance.
那慢慢的，他就带领我进入到一个忧伤、痛悔跟悔改的境界。
And after several days, he began to give me direction how I could bring everybody else together.
那几天之后，他也指示我怎么样把大家凝聚起来。
I was so thrilled, so happy to see the Lord graciously intervene like this.
那时候我心中真的是好兴奋、好开心，神能够这样子介入。
So around the 15th, 16th day of my fasting,
所以大概在我禁食到了第十五六天的时候
I felt like I had all the direction I needed.
我觉得我应该有的这些方向我都已经知道了。
I was full of excitement.
所以我内心相当的兴奋。
And I wanted to go and apply what the Lord had spoken.
所以我就想马上把主对我说的话拿去用出来。
But I had made a vow to fast for 30 days.
但是我跟神立了誓，我要禁食三十天。
And now I was just halfway through.
而现在呢，只到一半的时间。
So I went before the Lord.
因此呢，我就来到主前。
And I prayed, Lord, will you release me from my vow?
我就跟主说，主啊，你可以可不可以把我从我的誓约中释放出来
？Allow me to break the fast so that I can go and apply what you have shown me.
所以呢，我就不需要再禁食了，能够赶快把你告诉我的去运用出来。
But then the Lord spoke to me something I did not expect.
但是主就跟我讲了一些我预料不到的事。
He said to me,
他对我说
Do you know what I'm doing with your nation?
你知道我在你国家做什么吗
Nation?
国家
I said, I don't know.
我说我不知道耶。
I said, Do you know what I'm doing with the nations of the world?
他说你知道我在列国中做什么吗
I said, I don't know.
我说我也不知道耶。
I said, Do you think nations are important to me?
他又问我，你认为列国对我来讲是重要的吗
？I thought, well, they must be important, but I've never had any teaching anywhere on nations.
我心中就想，一定是重要的。可是呢，我从来没有听到关于列国的教导。
And he said to me,
他就对我说
，Continue fasting。
那么继续进食吧。
And I will teach you。
我就教你。
Amen。
Amen。
So I continued the fast, not asking anything anymore, but now I wanted to learn。
因此呢，我就继续我的进食。那接下来的时间，我没有向神求什么，我只想学习。
And God began slowly, brick by brick.Stone by stone to bring forth revelation concerning nations.
所以神就一砖一瓦的开始把关于列国的真理这样教导我。
One of the key scriptures he brought that really was a foundation for my understanding.
其中一个主要的经文呢，也就是我关于列国这个主题的认知最根本的。
Is in the book of Acts, chapter 17.
是在《使徒行传》第十七章
，verse 26 and 27。
二十六跟二十七节。
It says, "From one man he made every nation of men, that they should inhabit the whole earth, and he determined the times set for them, and the exact places where people should live. God did this."So that men would seek him and perhaps reach out for him and find him, although he's not far from each one of us.
使徒行传十七章二六二七节，他从一本造出万族的人，住在全地上，并且预先定准他们的年限和所住的疆界，要叫他们寻求神，或者可以揣摩而得。其实他离我们个人不远。
Amen.
Amen.
Someone say amen to God.
让我们对神说 Amen.
He began to show me that he is the author of nations.
所以他就开始让我知道列国是他所造的。
That he is the one who even determines where nations shall live.
列国的疆界也是他所定的。
He determines the exact places where people shall live.
他决定人们要住在哪一个区域。
And he determines the times appointed for them.
他也决定他们寻求神的时候。
The times appointed for certain nations to exist.
这些国家存在的年限也是神所定的。
Or to cease to exist.
或者是寻求存在的这个时间也是神定的。
He determines the times for the empires.
他决定了帝国的时间
to arise or to fall.
帝国的兴衰都是神所定的时候。
He determines the times for kingdoms to arise or to fall.
他也决定一个国度什么时候兴起，什么时候灭亡。
He also determines the times of visitation.
他也决定神造访那个国家的时间。
The times of the visitation of God upon a nation or a city.
神造访一个国家或一个城市的时间也是神所定的。
Do you remember when Jesus said to Jerusalem?
你记得耶稣对耶路撒冷所说的话吗
？Oh Jerusalem, oh Jerusalem, you have not known the time of your visitation.
Oh 耶路撒冷，耶路撒冷啊，你不知道神眷顾你的时候。
Therefore, you will not see me again until you learn to say, "Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord."
因此，除非你说奉主名来的是应当称颂的，你永远不再见我。
Jerusalem missed its timing at that time.
所以，耶路撒冷在神造访他的那个时刻，错过了那个时间。
And God began to show me that He has set the times for different nations at different times.
神就开始让我知道，他为列国定下了他们的时间。
And then He began to speak about our nation.
然后他开始讲到我的国家。
And he said to me, "I have been sending prophets from all over the world to come to your nation."
他告诉我说，我从列国差先知到你的国家。
I have revealed my plan to the people and the leaders of this nation.
我也把我对你们国家的计划向你的领袖们跟百姓们显明了。
That I want to bring a visitation upon your nation.
告诉他们说，我要来造访你的国家。
And I want to build you up into the destiny that I created you for.
我要建造你，好让你进入我创造你的命定中。
And I'm going to open the gates of the nations, and I'll promote men and women to go out and bless the nations.
我也要打开这城的这国的门户，而且让这里的人到列国当中去。
He said, "I have promised even to release new wealth to the nation."
我甚至应许要将新的财富释放到这个国家里。
There are minerals you've not yet discovered that are going to be discovered.
有一些你们从来没有开采过的矿产即将被发现。
I have promised to change the social setting of this nation.
我也要改变这个国家的社会地位。
And I promise to pour a new anointing and a fresh outpouring upon the land.
我也应许要把新的恩膏跟圣灵重新的浇灌在这片土地上。
And he said, I have spoken this for over 10 years.
他说这些话语我已经用十年的时间向你们传讲了。
It has been spoken in the big cities and in the small cities.
在大小的城市里面都传讲过了。
My people have heard it and have rejoiced, but have done nothing about it.
我的百姓们听到这些话语，欢欣快乐，但是什么都没做。
Everybody is busy in his own area.
因为每一个人都忙碌于在自己的区块里。
Everybody is busy in his own work.
每一个人都忙碌在自己的工作里。
But the time of fulfillment has come.
但是成就的时候到了。
The time of grace for your nation has come.
恩待你国家的时刻来临了。
If this nation would rise up,
如果这个国家兴起，
I'll begin to build it up.
我就要开始来建造它。
I'll begin to transform it.
我开始转化这个国。
I'll begin to put my name upon it.
我要开始把我的名放在这个国家上。
The nations of the world will begin to talk about this nation.
所以世上的列国会开始谈论这个国家。
They will recognize the work that I'm going to do.
他们也会认出我在这个国家所做的
工。I'm going to bring healing to this nation.
我要为这土地带来医治。
And I'm going to raise up men and women under the anointing.
我也要兴起这些带着恩膏的百姓。
And I will send them to the nations of the world.
我要差遣他们到世上的列国去。
But whom shall I send?
但是我要差遣谁？
Whom shall I send?
我要差谁去呢？
Because everyone hears and rejoices but does nothing about it.
因为每一个人听见都高兴欢喜，但什么都没做。
I began to cry.
所以我就开始哭泣。
And I was saying, Lord,
我就说主啊，
show me who you want to send. I'll pray for them.
你告诉我你要差谁去，我就为他们祷告。
I began to mention all the names of the key leaders in the country.
所以我就开始把国内很多重要的领袖的名字一一提出来。
I said, Lord, I'll pray for them.
我说主啊，我会为他们祷告。
Who do you want to use?
你要使用哪一些人？
But he asked me a question.
但是他问我一个问题，
Will you go?
你会去吗？
Will you rise up?
你会兴起吗？
I said, Who I am?
我说主啊，我是谁？
I'm nothing.
我是无名小卒啊。
I'm nobody.
我什么人都不是啊。
I don't have a platform in this nation.
在这个国家里面，我没有任何平台啊。
Who will listen to me?
谁会听我的话？
But he didn't argue with me.
但是
he didn't argue.
他没有跟我争论。
Instead, he gave me a prophetic word for the nation.
他乃是把对这个国的预言赐给我。
When I came out of my fasting,
当我30天的禁食过后，
I went to one of the top spiritual leaders in the country.
我就去找我们国家一个很高的属灵领袖。
And I said, "What do I do?"
我就问他说，我该怎么办呢？
This is what the Lord spoke to me. I don't know what to do.
这是主对我说的话，但是我不知道该怎么做。
He prayed.
他就祷告，
and then he said to me,
然后他对我说，
Make a list of all the key leaders of this nation.
你把这个国家里面关键的领袖名字都写下来，
In the different cities.
在不同的城市里，
make a list.
把他们的名字写下来，
and then go and see each of them one by one.
然后一个一个去拜访他们，
Tell them what you have shared with me.
告诉他们你所告诉我的，
and ask them,
问他们，
to bless this movement.
就是求他们来祝福这个运动。
Ask them to open their hearts and be part of it.
求他们打开心门，成为这运动的一部分。
And to open the way to all the churches upon which they have authority.
并且为所有他们治理下的教会呢，能够打开这样一个门。
And to pray for you.
然后为你祷告。
This is what amazed me when I was going around.
当我这样一一去拜访的时候，我很惊讶。
Almost all of them told me.
几乎他们每一个人都告诉我。
The Lord has ever spoken to me about that.
Has never.
Has ever.
神他有跟我说过这样的话。
We have ever heard that.
我们听过这样的话。
We started to pray.
所以我们开始祷告了。
But it took long, so we stopped.
但是呢，因为祷告了好久的时间了，所以我们就停了。
Another one said.
然后我说。
We heard about that.
其他的人说 我也听过了。
We talked to other leaders, but they did not respond.
我们也跟其他的领袖讲了，但是他们没有回应。
So, we left it.
所以我们也离开了。
And one leader,
有一个领袖。
When I spoke to him, he kept quiet. He said nothing.
当我跟他讲这些事的时候呢，他很安静，一句话都没说。
And when I finished, he said nothing. He said thank you for sharing.
当我讲完之后，他只说了一句谢谢，其他什么话都没说。
And I said, "Don't you have anything to say?"
我就问他说，难道你无话可说吗？
He said, "No."
他说没有。
I said, "Will you pray for us?"
我就问他说，你可以为我们祷告吗？
He said, "John, not now."
他说，约翰。现在不是时候。
He said, "You've done your part. Go."
你已经把你该做的做完了，走吧。
I thought, "My goodness."
我就说，我的天哪。
What kind of reception is this?
这是哪种领袖啊？
But 2-3 days later, he called me.
但是两三天之后，他打电话给我。
And he said, "The things you told me."
他说，你告诉我的话。
God spoke to me 2 years ago.
两年前，神就跟我说了。
And he told me to do what he has told you to do.
他告诉我去做他要你做的事
and I kept postponing.
但是我一直延迟
and he warned me
他也警告我
that if I did not do it
如果我不做
he's going to raise somebody else
他就会兴起其他人来做
to do it
来做这事
so he said when you sat there and talked to me
因此他说当你坐在那里跟我讲这话
I was under so much guilt and condemnation
我里面真的有很大的罪恶感而且觉得被定罪了
I had to go back to the Lord and repent
我必须要先回到主的面前悔改
and ask for forgiveness.
求他赦免我
Now I am here to say to you.
现在我要对你说
I'm behind you.
我支持你
I'll serve you.
我会服务
I'll support you.
我也会支持你
I'll support financially.
在财务上支持你
Anything the Lord wants to do.
神要做的一切我都支持你
Praise the name of the Lord.
赞美主
That we began to go around across the whole nation.
所以我们就开始到国家里面每一个地方去。
We were taking a message to the nation.
我们就带着这个信息走遍全国。
To every denomination.
去拜访每一个宗派。
To every ethnic group.
每一个族群。
To every city.
每一个城市。
Telling them this is what the Lord has said.
告诉他们说这就是主说的。
There are 3 things I want to share with you.
我要跟各位分享三件事
which are important for you to understand even for your own nation.
为你自己的国家你要明白这三点很重要
的 I will not go into details because we don't have a lot of time.
因为我们时间有限所以我不会进入细节来讲
the Lord had told us
但是主他告诉我们
every nation on earth
在地上的每一个国家
exists for a purpose in God.
他们的存在在神的里面都有他的目的的。
God has got a purpose for every nation on earth.
所以神对世上的列国都有神的旨意。
For every people group.
对每一个族群都有他的旨意。
He has ordained an appointed time for each nation.
而且他也为每一个国家设立了预定的时候。
And he said, when the appointed time comes,
他说当那预定的时候来到
he sends his word to that nation.
他就会把他的话语拆到那个国家去
to rise up and begin to take its position.
让那个国家能够兴起站到他的定位上
If that nation does not respond,
如果那个国家不回应
after so many, many times of him coming and speaking to it,
在他来到这个国家而且对这些国家说这些话很多次以后
Then he passes on
他就会从这个国家走过去了
And when that happens
而当这样的情形发生
Then that nation begins to experience the consequences and repercussions of the sins of that nation
那么那个国家就会开始经历那个国的罪孽所带来的后果。
In other words, the sins of the nation catch up with the nation.
换句话说，那国的罪孽追上了那个国家。
Do you remember Sodom and Gomorrah?
各位记得索多玛跟俄摩拉吗
？God said, "The sins of the land have reached the outcry of the sin has reached up to me."
神说，那片土地上罪孽哭喊的声音已经达到我的耳中了。
I have come down to see whether.The things are like that.
所以我下来查看事情是否真是如此。
In Ezekiel chapter 22, verse 30.
在以西结书二十二章三十节
，The Lord said, and I looked for a man among them who would repair the hedge and stand before me on behalf of the land.
主说，我在他们当中寻找一人，重修墙垣，为这国站在破口上守望。
So that I may not destroy it, I may not punish it.
好让我不灭绝这国。
And I found none.
竟找不到一人。
And the Lord told us,
主他告诉我们
，Times of visitation.
我造访的时候
come before times of judgment
会在审判之前
times of visitation
所以造访的时刻
come before the sins of the land begin to pull down the consequences of their being committed in the land
会在那片土地上面所犯的这些罪孽开始带出它的后果之前来到
when a nation respondsTo the calling of the Lord.
所以当一个国家起来回应神的呼召
and humbles itself in brokenness and repentance,
在忧伤痛悔跟悔改当中谦卑自己
and begins to cleanse themselves and call upon the Lord's mercy,
开始洁净自己呼求主的怜悯
the Lord releases his mercy and grace upon that land.
主就会将他的怜悯跟恩惠释放到那片土地上
He cleanses the land.
他就会洁净那片土地
He forgives the land.
他就会赦免那地上的罪
And he pours out his Holy Spirit.
然后把他的圣灵倾倒下来
Amen.
Amen.
Go back and read about revival histories.
你若回顾复兴的历史
Most revivals broke out after a heightened season of wickedness.
通常复兴总是在很剧烈的这个邪恶的行径之后才发生的。
But God, instead of punishing and judging them,
但是神没有去刑罚或者是审判
begins to call them to himself.
他乃是开始在那个光景里面把百姓呼召到自己身边。
When they respond in humility and brokenness,
当这群百姓在自己的破碎跟悔改当中起来回应
he turns it round.
他就会翻转那个处境
and blesses them.
祝福他们
Remember Ezekiel 33?
记得以西结书三十三章吗
He says, if I speak to a nation,
说如果我对一国说
that it shall surely die,
这国必定灭亡
and that nation humbles itself
但是那国谦卑自己
and turns from its wickedness
转离他的恶行
then I will repent of the evil I was going to bring upon it
那么我就后悔不把那恶降在他们当中了
and instead I will bless it
反而要来祝福他们
but if I say to a nation
但我若对一国说
that you will indeed be blessed
你将蒙福
But that nation turns away from my goodness.
但是那国转离我的良善
And does not do according to my desire.
且不按着我心中所渴望的去行
Then I repent of the goodness I pronounced over it.
那么我就后悔对他们所说的这些良善的话语
And I bring upon it the disaster that is equal to their sins.
那么我就会降下他们罪孽所配得的灾害
Praise the name of the Lord.
赞美主的名
These are the words God was speaking to us.
这是神他对我们说的话。
He was saying, I'm going to visit, I'm going to pour out my spirit upon your nation.
他说我要造访你的国家，我要将我的灵倾倒在你的国家。
Not because you have been good.
不是因为你们国是好的国。
In effect, the sins of the land are crying for judgment.
事实上，你们土地上面的罪已经在呼求公义公正的审判。
But I'm having mercy upon you.
但是我对你们有怜悯。
If you will answer the call,
如果你起来回应这呼召
I will lead you into my ways.
我就带领你们进入到我的道路里
I will cleanse you.
我就洁净你们
I'll forgive your sins.
我就赦免你们的罪
I will bless the land.
我就祝福这片土地
I will pour out my Holy Spirit.
我就将我的圣灵倾倒
And I'll bring revival to the land.
并为这土地带来复兴
But that is not all.
但不仅如此
I will heal the land.
我也要医治这片土地
I will begin to heal the wounds of the land.
我医治这片土地上面的所有伤害
I'll begin to unite your land.
我要开始让你们的土地能够合一
And I will begin to bring the nation together.
而且我让你的国家能够整合起来
I will bless you materially.
我正在物质上面祝福你们
And I will promote your nation amongst other nations.
我也使你的国能够高过世上的列国
If you will pay heed to my call.
若你聆听且顺从我的呼召
Praise the name of the Lord.
赞美主的名。
And said, then I will bring you into the destiny that I have for you.
然后他说，我就把你们带进我为你们所定的命定中。
And under the anointing of that destiny,
在那命定的恩膏下，
you will go out into the world.
你们将要到列国去，
and be a blessing to other nations.
成为列国的祝福。
Amen.
Amen.
And says that is the redemptive purpose of God for the nation.
这个就是神对国家救赎性的旨意。有些国家的恩赐呢是属于自然界的，有些是属灵的。
The natural gifts are already there in the people.
自然界的恩赐呢已经在当地百姓当中了。
In their character,
在他们的性格里。
In their ways,
在他们的方式。
In their nature,
生活方式，在他们的国家里。
They are also in the land.
所以已经在那土地上了。
The natural resources of the land,
比如说自然的资源。
Then the wealth of the land,
土地中的财富。
Even the positioning of the land,
以及那个土地的位置。
God wants to use all of that. He is interested in all of that.
神对这一切他都有兴趣的，他要使用这一切。
Because it is Him who decides the exact places where people shall live.
因为人群住在什么样的土地上面，这是神所定的。
And the third one,
第三，
this is very important.
这件非常重要。
We call it redemptive molding.
我们说救赎性的塑造。
That is the shaping, God shaping the nation using the history of that nation.
神透过那个国家的历史来塑造那个国家。
Let me take the example of Joseph in the Bible.
让我用圣经里面的约瑟来做一个例子。
God spoke to him his destiny.
神告诉约瑟他的命定。
He was going to be a ruler.
他要成为一个统治者。
Even his father and mother and brothers would all bow down to him.
就连他的父母跟哥哥们也要向他跪拜。
You remember the dreams he had.
各位记得约瑟所做的梦。
So that was his destiny.
所以这是约瑟的命定。
What about his gifts?
那他的恩赐呢？
The gifts were in him.
恩赐已经在他里
面。Some were spiritual, as you know, he had the ability to interpret dreams.
有些是属灵的恩赐，比方说解梦。
Some were natural, just who he was.
有些呢是自然人的恩赐，就是约瑟这个人。
But what about the redemptive molding of God?
那么我们来看看神对他生命中那救赎性的塑造如何。
The molding is the path of destiny through which God will take a person to bring him to his desired end.
那个救赎的塑造就是这个人的一生当中他所经历的途程，神带领他进入到神要他进入的那个位置。
Joseph had to be betrayed by his brothers.
所以约瑟必须经历被哥哥们的背叛。
That was very painful.
是一个痛苦的经验。
They almost killed him.
哥哥们几乎把他杀了。
Then they sold him into slavery.
然后他们把他卖当奴隶。
Very painful.
所以对他来讲是一个痛苦的经历。
Very, very disappointing and hurting.
是让他心中很失望很受伤的
事。 So he goes into a foreign land.
因此约瑟到了一个外国之地。
He leaves home.
他离开了家乡。
He misses home.
他想念他的家。
But he can no longer return.
但是他没有办法再回去了。
He goes out into Egypt.
他下到埃及去了。
And he begins to learn how to live there under servitude.
然后他在那边必须要以仆人的身份来过活。
He becomes beloved in the house of Potiphar.
他在波提法的家中是主人所爱的。
He begins to gain some joy of life.
他在他的生活里面也有一些乐趣。
Then the wife of Potiphar rises up against him.
然后波提法的太太起来抵挡他。
And he ends up wrongly accused in prison.
后来因为诬告，他就被关到监狱里。
That is painful.
所以这是很痛苦的。
That is hurting.
这个是很令人深受伤的。但是约瑟经过这些。
He doesn't know what God is doing.
约瑟不明白神正在做怎样的事。
He may feel life is unfair.
他觉得生命是不公平的。
But God knows what he's doing.
但是神他知道他在做什么。
In prison, he meets officials from the palace of the Pharaoh.
在监狱里面，他遇见法老王宫里面的一些官
员。They have dreams that they don't know how to interpret.
这些人呢，也做了梦，但不知如何解梦。
He interprets them for them.
所以约瑟替他们解梦。
And he tells the man, "Remember me when you go out."
然后告诉一个人说，你出去以后，请你记得我。
The man goes out.
所以那个人离开了监狱。
He does not remember him.
但是他不记得约瑟了。
And definitely, Joseph is disappointed.
所以约瑟再一次失望。
But is God disappointed?
但是神失望吗？
No.
没有。
God is working a plan.
因为神正在进行他的计划。
Every detail is right on time.
神的每一个细节都是在他精确的时间点上的。
And when the time is right,
当时机对了，
God gives a dream to Pharaoh.
神就让法老做了梦，
which nobody can interpret.
没有人可以解他的梦。
Then the official remembers Joseph.
然后那时候那个 官员才记得了约瑟。
And Joseph is brought out of prison.
所以约瑟从监狱里面被提出来。
At the time ready for his destiny.
这个就是他进入他命定的时刻了。
The next thing he becomes a leader in Egypt.
接下来他就成为埃及的宰相了。
Hallelujah.
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 Do you understand that?
各位明白吗？
God does the same thing with nations.
对列国，神也是这样对待。
Nations go through different things.
列国也经历不同的历史。
Through conquest.
通过征服。
Through colonialism sometimes.
有时候通过殖民主义。
Through abuse by other nations.
或其他国家对这国的侵害。
Maybe the people are pushed out of their nation.
或许那国的国民被从自己的家乡赶出去了。
They go out and live in another land.
然后住在另外一片土地上。
And they think this is not fair.
他们心中也觉得这是不公平的。
This is not good.
这是不好的。
This is painful.
这是痛苦的。
But they work hard.
但是他们很努力。
They begin to build themselves.
他们开始建造自己。
Then another problem comes.
但是另外的问题又出现了。
And they cry.
他们哭求。
This is not fair.
他们再次说不公平。
But God knows what he is doing.
但是神知道神在做什么。
God uses those things
神使用这些事
to build the character of the nation
来建造这个国家的性格
to build the sensitivity of the people
让人们心中有那种敏锐度
The Lord was speaking to us in Uganda
神对我们乌干达的人说
And he said, you hate Idi Amin
说你们恨恶阿敏
You hate the dictators who ruled over you
你们恨恶那些统治里面的独裁
者 Because you don't understand what is happening in the spirit
因为你们不明白
You are not fighting against flesh and blood.
因为你们不是与属血气的在征战。
And all the experience you went through,
你所经历的这些种种
all the pain,
所有的痛苦
has been working character inside of you.
其实都在塑造你们内在的性格。
Do you remember what it says in the book of Romans?
记得罗马书怎么说吗？
That we rejoice in our sufferings.
我们在我们的苦难中欢欣快乐。
Because suffering works patience.
因为苦难能够使我们有耐心
Patience works character
耐心能够使我们有性格出来
And character brings us to God's planning
而我们所塑造出来的性格能够使我们进入到神的计划里
The Lord began to show us
所以神开始让我们明白
That as a nation we had come into an anointing of prayer and travail that was not very common to many other nations
以整个国家来讲我们就进入到一种取劳祷告的恩膏当中，这不是很多国家所具备的。
That we had come to an anointing of bringing to birth through travailing intercession.
我们通过取劳的代祷，能够把这样子的一个恩膏带出来。
And that because of the powers of darkness that had tormented the nation, oppressed the nation.
因为折磨跟压制这个国家的黑暗权势。
The nation had developed a sensitivity to the spiritual realm where we are able to discern the powers of darkness in the spirit.
发展出这个国家对黑暗权势有一种属灵的敏锐性，能够去分辨黑暗权势在哪里。
And that the nation had gained a platform in the spirit of authority to deal with these powers and break these powers on national level.
所以这个国家就在属灵的层次上面有这一种权柄，能够去对付遮盖整个国家的幽暗权势。
So although we had painful and sad experiences,
所以虽然我们走过一些痛苦、令我们伤心难过的经历，
the Lord was using everything to bring us to the purposes He had for us.
但是主使用我们历史中所发生的种种，带领我们进入到他的命令跟旨意里。
In Romans chapter 8, it says,
罗马书八章说，
To those who love God and are called according to His purposes,
对那些爱神又而且是按着神的旨意受膏的人，
All things work together for good.
万事都是互相效力的。
Someone say amen to God.
让我们对神说 Amen.
How does that relate with you?
那么这些跟各位有什么关系呢？
When God says, Taiwan, I have a destiny for you.
当神对台湾说，台湾啊，我有给你的命定。
That is God's redemptive purpose for Taiwan.
那个讲的就是神对台湾救赎的目的。
It is God's calling on Taiwan.
是神对台湾的呼召。
And where there is calling, there are gifts.
既然有呼召，就有恩赐。
And there are gifts in the natural.
自然界里面有自然界的恩赐。
In the people.
在人原本的身上。
In their nature.
在他们的本性里。
In the way they are made.
在他们受造的那个样子里
in the land,
在这片土地上
in the wealth of the land,
以及土地的财富上
and in the positioning of the land,
以及土地的位置上
all those things can be used by God to cause that nation to fulfill its destiny.
这一切都可以被神使用，让这国能够成就他的命定。
But what about molding?
但是我们来看看塑造这一块又怎样呢？
What about molding?
如何塑造呢？
You go back and look at your history.
各位回顾你们国家的历史。
Look where the nation came from.
看看这个国是怎么开始的。
Look at the steps that the Lord used.
以及神怎么样一步一步带领这国走过。
Some of them were painful.
有些历史的步伐是痛苦的。
Some of them were hurting.
有些是令人难过、受伤的。
They brought disappointment.
让我们人失望。
Maybe like Joseph.
或许就像约瑟一样。
They sent you out and you feel, oh, we miss that land.
他们把你们赶出去，哦，让你们说我们是远离了我们的家乡了。
It was painful.
所以这是一个痛苦的经历。
And it is there in the fabric of the nation.
但是这样的伤痛就在这个国家的骨子里。
Other people were here.
还有其他的人已经在这里。
They are original to the land.
他们是这土地上的原住民。
So the coming in of people from another land was a painful experience.
因此，对从其他土地进到这片土地的这些人来讲，原住民也觉得是一个痛苦的经历。
Yes, maybe there was a lot of injustice.
是的，或许这土地上有很多不公的事情。
Injustice which is still painful inside of us.
这些不公的事让我们里面依然痛。
But we need to understand.
但我们需要明白
the redemptive molding of God for a nation.
神对一个国家这种救赎性塑造的过程
that all things eventually work together for good.
而万事最终总是互相效力的。
It is God who determines the exact places where people shall live.
是神决定人们要住在哪一个地方。
And the times appointed for them.
以及神给他们预定的时候
and he brings them and molds them into one people
他就把他们带在一起，把他们塑造成为同一个百姓。
He uses those experiences in their history to build their character
他使用他们历史当中的这些种种的事件来建造他们的性格
to build their their determination.
来建造他们里面的决心。
To build their ability to face challenges.
来建造他们面对挑战的勇气。
Also to build their sensitivity to the other people of the world who may be suffering similar things they suffered.
也建造他们里面的敏感度，让他们敏锐其他国家类似受苦受难的经历的。
Why is it that Jesus is able to heal us?
为什么耶稣能够医治我们呢？
Because he was wounded.
因为他也曾受伤。
By his stripes we are healed.
因他的鞭伤我们得医治。
By the things he suffered we are set free.
借着他所受的苦我们得自由。
The same principle applies to other people too.
所以同样的原则也适用在其他人身上。
Jesus said to Peter,
耶稣对彼得说，
Satan has asked to sift you.
撒旦他已经要得你。
But I've prayed for you.
但是我已经为你祷告了。
After you have overcome,
在你胜过之后，
you'll strengthen your brethren.
你就要来坚固你的弟兄们。
The same thing applies to nations.
这同样的原则也可以运用在国家中。
When you go through your experiences,
当一个国家走过他们的经历，
painful experiences,
痛苦的经历。
Unfortunate experiences.
不幸的经历。
Sometimes experiences of captivity.
有时候是被掳的经历。
Of colonialism.
殖民的经历。
Of exploitation.
被人家剥削的经历。
Of woundedness.
受伤的经历。
When you overcome that cloud.
但是当我们能够胜过这乌云的时候。
And you arise to stand in the destiny of the Lord.
当我们能够兴起站在主为我们给我们的命定当中的时候。
Then the Lord makes you a blessing to other people.
那么主就可以使我们成为他人的祝福。
Then you can take healing to other nations.
我们就能够把医治带到列国中。
Then you can take hope to other nations.
我们就能够为列国带来盼望。
Then you can encourage others who are down.
我们就可以鼓励那些失落的人。
Praise the name of the Lord.
赞美主的名。
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now listen.
现在请听。
As the Lord was teaching us all these things.
当主将这一切教导我们的时候
，We said, "Okay, what are we supposed to do?"
我们就跟主说，好吧，那接着我们要做什么呢
？And he said to us,
他就对我们说
，"It's going to take a process."
这需要一段过程的。
It can't happen at once.
它没有办法一下就发生了。
It's going to take a process.
需要走过一个历程。
And I will lead you step by step.
但是我会一步一步引导你。
The first step, he said,
他说第一步
，Arise.
兴起
go to the north,
往北走
go to the south,
往西走
go to the east,
往南走
and go to the west,
往东西走
and set up an altar,
在那里烛坛
an altar that will cry for the nation,
一个能够为国家来哭求的坛
go and call my people,
所以你去呼召我的百姓
to set up those four altars in the land,
在土地上烛坛
and let them take responsibility,
让他们为这片土地负起责任
to cry for the nation.
为这国家来哭求
And he said, I give you 6 months to do that.
他说这一步我给你六个月的时间完成
So, we got busy.
所以我们就开始忙起
来 Every day we were traveling to one part of the nation or to the other.
每一天呢我们就是到这个国家的某一个部分或另一个部分
We were talking to pastors.
我们到处跟牧师们谈
Sharing the prophetic word he has given us.
把神给予我们的预言跟牧师们分
享。Calling them, please come together in your city.
然后呼召他们说，请在你的城市里面齐心聚集。
Begin to raise an altar in the city for the nation.
开始在城里面筑起一个为国家的祷告的祭坛。
It was not easy.
这是不容易啊。
And we had to deal with things we did not understand.
而且我们必须要去面对一些我们不明白的事。
In one area,
在某一个区域
we found the pastors very united.
我们发现当地的牧者们很合一
And we thought, that is wonderful.
我们就想哎呀这真的太棒了
So we can speak to them together.
所以我们可以跟他们一起讲
And the Lord said to us,
但主就告诉我们
It's not them.
不是他们
It's the spiritual atmosphere you are dealing with.
你们现在在面对的是那属灵的氛围
There is a hold in the spirit holding that entire region.
因为在那个区域的上空有一股幽暗的权势紧紧地抓住那个地区。
And I said, I want to teach you how to deal with the spiritual atmosphere over cities and regions.
所以神说，现在我要开始教导你们怎么样对付那些掌管辖整个区域或城市上空的幽暗权势。
It's a long story. We cannot go into every detail.
这是一个很长的故事，所以没有办法告诉各位细节。
But it involved a few things.
但是这其中包含几点。
Going back in the customs of the land.
第一，要回去当地的习俗去查考。
Going back in the covenants and rituals of the land.
回到当地的一些以前所立的约跟仪式当中去研究。
Going back in some of the ceremonies and the carnivals that were being held periodically in the land.
以及当地不定期举行的一些节庆或者一些庆贺。
And showing us the ungodly values that were embedded in that society.
以及那个社会当中哪一些不敬虔的一些价值体系。
When he showed us all of those things,
所以当神把这些都让我们看见的时候，
we called a fast for 30 days.
我们就开始了另一个30天的禁食。
And we prayed.
我们祷告。
We cried to God.
我们对神哭求。
Give us victory, Lord.
主啊，将胜利赐给我们。
Over these powers.
能够胜过这些黑暗权势。
Give us victory.
赐给我们得胜。
Over the minds of your people.
能够赢得人们的心思意念。
Help them to turn away from these things.
让你的百姓能够转离这些。
And to turn to you and recovenant themselves to you.
能够转向你，并且重新与你立约。
We went back to that region in the east.
所以我们就回到东边的这个区域。
And we had a much bigger crowd coming.
那这一次我们回去呢，这个聚集的群众更多了。
We shared and we taught and we explained.
所以我们就跟他们讲了，也教导了，也说明了。
Then the pastors who were there said, "Wow, we now can see it."
结果那个牧师们就说，哇，现在我们明白了。
They joined together. There were only 6 pastors.
他们呢就合一起来，其实他们只有6个人。
They said, "We are going to take this responsibility."
他们就回忆说，现在我们要来拿起这个责任，
to go to other pastors,
去找其他的牧师，
and explain to them what the Lord is doing,
以及向他们说明主在做的事。
We are going to raise up people in our churches,
我们也要在教会里面兴起弟兄姊妹，
to start praying that God will open up our land,
开始祷告让神来开启我们的土地。
The next time we went back to their city,
我们下一次再回到他们的城市。
There were about 200 churches involved in the move.
就有大约200间教会投入在这个运动当中了。
The pastors were meeting together now.
所以现在牧者们都会聚集。
They were coming together periodically and praying together.
他们有定期的祷告会。
They had raised up their congregations and they were praying together.
他们兴起弟兄姊妹们一起祷告。
Every week they were holding all-night prayer meetings and dealing with the powers of darkness in their region.
每一个晚上，每一个周，他们有通宵祷告，来对付他们区域上空的黑暗权势。
Then they asked us questions about the powers and we also did not know.
那他们也问我们关于一些我们自己也不懂的一些关于黑暗权势的问题。
We told them you need to raise up a team made up of people from different churches.
那我们就跟他们说，你需要兴起一支团队，那团队的成员呢是不同教会的会友组成的。
To go and begin to do a research.
那你们要开始去做研究。
In the origin of these rituals and ceremonies and covenants you have.
去研究当地的一些仪式，一些约跟一些原来的习俗。
They accepted to do that.
所以他们接受了这个挑战。
They raised up a team.
他们就兴起了一支团队。
One pastor said, "I will lead the team myself."
其中一个牧师说，我自己来带领这支团队。
Other pastor said, "We will fund it."
那另外一个牧师说，那在财务上面我们来供应。
They began to do the research.
所以他们就开始研究。
And they unearthed a lot of roots of darkness in the land.
结果他们就发现了那片土地上面很多幽暗权势的根源。
Then they began the cleansing of the land.
接着就开始洁净那地。
They began to repent for the sins of their forefathers.
开始为先祖所犯的罪孽跟过犯来悔改。
They began to wage war and break these powers.
然后开始对幽暗权势来宣战，来打破那个权势。
The results were spectacular.
结果带出来的结果真的是奇妙的。
The newspapers wrote about these results.
甚至报纸都做报道了。
The government officials began to participate in the programs.
政府的官员也开始投入在他们的这个运动当中。
Up to today,
一直到今天
，That area of Uganda has the best prayer network in the whole country.
乌干达的那个区域有整个国家最强的祷告网络。
And when there is any national program.
有任何国家的活动
，without asking them，
我们不需要去求他们。
The leaders get together，
这些领袖们就会聚集在一起。
They raise money，
他们就会一起来募款。
And they send it and say， let that money help to do this work for our nation。
然后把这个钱就送来说，让这笔钱能够帮助你们来做成这个国家级的活动。
They rose up to a completely different level。
所以这个区域的教会就掀起到一个完全不一样的层级。
Hallelujah，
Amen。
The same thing began to happen in different parts of the nation.
同样的事情也开始在我们国家不同的区域里面发生。
In different degrees.
不同的层次。
And different ways.
不同的方式。
Some parts completely refused.
但也有一些区域是完全拒绝的。
And later on, after a few years.
但是几年之后。
The difference could begin to show.
那个。不一样哦，差异就开始显明出来了。
Let me wrap this point together so we don't miss it.
但是呢，现在让我做一个总结，让各位能够明白。
The Bible says.
圣经说。
In the book of Leviticus, chapter 28.
在利未记二十八章里面。
And Deuteronomy, no, chapter 18.
不对，是十八章。
Leviticus 18.
利未记十八章。
And Deuteronomy 18.
以及生命记十八章
God is talking about the ways of the nations.
在那里神提到列国的方式
Their ways in idolatry.
那些偶像崇拜的方式
Their ways in sexual immorality.
在性上面不道德的方式
Their ways in covenants with death.
以及与死亡立约的方式
Their ways of injustice.
不公不义的方式
Their ways of abuse.
以及虐待的方式
their ways of taking their children and offering them to their gods
让他们的儿女禁火献给假神的方式
God says
神说
those things have defiled the land
那些事都玷污了那片土地
they have polluted the land
他们污染了土地
they have brought a curse on the land
因此为土地带来咒诅
they have given legal ground to the powers of darkness to oppress the land.
让黑暗权势有合法的权利来压制那片土地。
And before the nation can rise into its destiny,
在一个国家能够掀起进入它的命令之前。
Hallelujah.
Amen.
To God be the glory.
荣耀归给我们的神。
Come on, give God the praise.
让我们赞美我们的主 Hallelujah!
Give God the praise.
赞美我们的神
You remember what he says in the Bible?
记得他圣经里面怎么说吗
Hallelujah!
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 Amen.
Amen.
He says in the Bible,
在圣经里面他说
When the people shall sin against him,
当人们犯罪得罪他
and his wrath is about to be poured out,
而他即将要倾倒他的愤怒
there shall be a sign of the rainbow,
但是每当他们看见彩虹的记号
and God will turn away from his wrath,
神就会转离他的烈怒
Amen, Amen, thank you Lord,
感谢主
and he will remember his covenant,
他就会纪念他的约。
Oh, God is good.
我们的神真好。
God is good.
神真好。
Come on, give him the praise.
来呀，让我
们赞美他。Lift up your hands and give him a hand clap worthy of God Almighty.
让我们向神举起我们的手，用他配得的赞美的掌声来归给他。
Praise you, Jesus. Praise you, Lord.
Yes, we praise you.
Father, Father, your word is a living word.
是的，神啊，你的话。
Your promises are everlasting. You are a wonderful God. You promise and you fulfill your word. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Bless you, Jesus. Bless you, Jesus. Bless you, Jesus.
Bless you, Jesus.
Praise the Lord.
赞美主。
Tell your neighbor, this is for real.
告诉你旁边人说，这一切都是真的。
Come on, tell your neighbor, this is for real. It's not a joke.
告诉旁边人说，这都是真的，不是开玩笑的。
Amen.
Amen.
I believe that the grace of the Lord is hanging over us.
我相信主的恩惠正笼罩着我们。
I believe that the hand of favor is stretched out upon this nation right now.
我相信主他恩待的手正伸向这个国家。
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
感谢主。
Thank you, Jesus.
感谢耶稣。
Let us try and wrap this together very quickly.
所以让我们很快的做一个结论。
And then we want to pray and take this position.
然后我们要来祷告，进入到这个位置上。
Amen.
Amen.
I was saying to you.
所以我对各位说。
That the ways of the nations.
列国之道。
Pollute the land.
污秽了这个土地。
They defile the land.
他们玷污了这个土地。
They cause the land to be held back from the purposes of God.
所以这土地没有办法成就神对他的旨意。
So the Lord was teaching us.
所以主他教导我们。
As you prepare the nation to rise into its destiny.
当你预备这个国家要进到他的命定里。
You need to go back to the roots of the nation.
你需要回到这个国家的根源。
And break the unholy covenants.
打破那些不洁的约。
Which your forefathers made.
也是你的先祖们所立的约。
And separate, break the connection with the idolatry of the land.
打破这片土地跟偶像的牵连。
Which your forefathers established in the land.
是我们的先祖在这片土地上面所设立的。
And bring repentance for the injustice that has been committed in the land in the past.
也为这片土地在过往所犯下一些不公不义之罪来悔改。
He said, cleanse the land, cleanse the land.
他说，洁净土地，洁净土地。
And as you do that, I will have mercy and I'll forgive the sins of your nation.
当你这样做的时候，我必怜悯你们，我必赦免你们国家的罪。
Amen.
Amen.
He says every man should go back to his family.
他说每一个人都回到自己的家。
And deal with the issues in their family.
处理他们家庭中的事。
And every man should go back to their city.
每一个人回到自己的城里
and deal with the sins of the city.
对付那城中的罪
And then we discovered later we needed even pastors to go back to their churches.
所以后来我们也发现连牧师也要回到自己的教会
and deal with the sins that have been committed in the churches, some of which are still holding a cloud upon the church.
处理在教会当中所曾发生过的一切罪孽跟过犯有一些罪今天还抓住了教会
In other words
换句话说
We needed to begin to do a cleansing of the land
我们必须要开始进行洁净土地的工作
And a breaking of connection with the negative roots
打破所有一切负面根源的连结
But the Lord said to us
但主对我们说
You are not ready yet
你们还没预备好。
Continue spreading the prayer across the nation.
所以要继续在全国设立祷告的祭坛。
To every city.
在每一个城市里。
To every district.
每一区。
To every county.
每一县。
Spread the prayer.
你们要拓展这些祷告。
Spread the net of prayer.
要拓展这张祷告的网
and raise the levels of prayer
并且提升祷告的层次
because prayer weakens the bondage of darkness on the land
因为祷告能够削弱黑暗权势对土地的捆绑
as prayer rises in the land the darkness weakens and weakens
当这片土地不断有祷告上升的时候黑暗权势就越来越弱了
so we began to build the momentum of prayer
因此我们就开始建造祷告的动力
We went to every city
我们到每一个城市
Every district
每一区
Every denomination
每一个宗派
Every sphere of society
在社会的每一个层面里
We went into businesses
我们进到职场
We went into government offices
进入到政府
We went everywhere raising our prayer altars
我们在社会的每一个层面里面都来主祷告的祭坛
And then the Lord said to us
然后主他对我们说
Now The next step is ready.
现在你们已经预备好要走下一步了。
The experiences you've gone through as a nation.
现在你们全国共同的这个经历。
Have built the character of the nation.
已经建造了这个国家的性格。
But something else also has come to the nation.
但是还有一些事情也临到了这国。
The pain.
就是那痛苦。
Is still inside of you.
痛苦依然藏在你们心里。
You are a wounded people.
所以你们是一群受伤的百姓。
Your families are wounded.
你们的家人受伤。
Your pastors are wounded.
牧者们受伤。
Your churches are wounded.
教会受伤。
Your cities are wounded.
城市受伤。
The whole nation is wounded.
整个国家是受伤的。
You need to bring healing to the land.
所以你需要为这片土地带来医治。
You need to start speaking forgiveness into the land.
要开始对这片土地宣告赦罪。
You cannot be healed of the inner wounds if you don't forgive.
你若不饶恕，内在的伤就永远不得医治。
Says pray for forgiveness.
所以开始为饶恕来祷告吧。
Pray for the grace of forgiveness to come upon the nation.
祷告求那饶恕的恩典能够临到这国。
Forgiveness in politics.
在政治层面的饶恕。
The injustices that have been committed in politics.
在政治的层面上面所犯下的不公不义
之事。The bloodshed.
所流的血
the ethnic tensions
以及所做的这些污蔑的欺压的事
the tribal hatreds
以及在部落之间的憎恨
the denominational contentions
以及宗派之间的冲突
the disagreements and discontent between pastor and congregation
牧师跟牧师之间牧师跟会友之间那些没有办法同心合意那些争论
Between husband and wife.
在丈夫跟妻子之间的。
Between parents and children.
在父母跟儿女之间的。
He says, bring healing, bring healing.
他说带来医治带来医治。
With forgiveness.
用饶恕带下医治。
And he led us into a season of praying just for forgiveness to come into the hearts of the people.
所以他就带领我们进入到另外一个季节我们只祷告一件事就是让饶恕进到人们的心中。
We took a whole year.
我们用了一整年的时间
going all across the nation.
到全国每一个地区
speaking brokenness and repentance and forgiveness.
开始传讲那忧伤痛悔悔改以及饶恕的信息
Speaking reconciliation
宣讲和好的信息
Speaking release of grudges
宣讲把心中的那个 仇恨能够放手让它过去
Speaking to people to let go of historical injustice
也告诉人们把历史当中这些不公不义放手让它过去吧
Then we had a national gathering
How I woman Joe it's a triangle
for 2 weeks.
两个礼拜的时间
we were gathered there from every part of the nation.
从这国的每一个区域都有人前来聚集
all the denominations represented there.
所有的宗派都有人代表前来
we had government officials.
我们也有政府的官员
members of parliament.
以及我们国会的这个
military generals.
以及将军们
police commanders.
警察的这些
judges,
领袖们法官们
all kinds of people,
各行各业的人
and we were praying,
所以我们祷告
forgiveness and release,
我们祷告求饶恕能够被释放出来
两个礼拜 repenting to one another,
我们彼此悔改认罪
releasing one another,
彼此饶恕
and then we were praying for our nation which had been dedicated to Islam by Idi Amin,
然后我们为我们的国家祷告，因为这个国家曾在阿敏的手下献给回教。
And we invited the president.
所以我们就邀请了总统来。
And he came for the first time.
第一次总统来参加我们的聚会。
To that kind of meeting.
来参加这样的聚集。
And while he was there with us.
当他跟我们在一起的时候。
We challenged him.
我们就要挑战我们的总统。
Will you return this nation to God?
你愿意把这个国家再归给什么？
Will you as the head of state dedicate this nation to God?
身为这一国的元首，你愿意把这个国献给什么？
And then the president stood up.
总统站了起来。
He took the flag of the nation.
他就拿起我们国家的国旗。
All of us standing up before the Lord.
我们所有的人都站在主的面前。
With all the press and the media there.
所有的媒体跟新闻报纸都来了。
Both local media and international media.
地区性的以及国际的媒体都来了。我们就拿起国旗。
Gave it in the hands of the intercessors, the prayer movement.
交给这个祷告运动的代祷者手中。
As a prophetic sign.
成为一个先知性的记号。
To give the nation back to the lordship of Jesus Christ.
就是把这个国重新交回主耶稣基督的治理
中。Oh, hallelujah.Hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh my God, we rejoiced.
Oh, 是的，神啊。
We felt like we were going to die.
我们真的是高兴的快死了。
And the Lord spoke to us.
主就对我们说。
And said, now.
说现在。
The authority.
权柄。
To determine where this nation goes.
决定这个国家未来的权柄。
Is in the hands that are called, of the people who are called by the name of the Lord.
是在那称呼神名下子民的手中。
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
赞美主的名。
I could go on and on.
我可以不断地讲下去。
But I said I'm going to share testimony and pull out principles as we go.
但是最先我说过，我要跟各位分享见证，然后从这些见证当中分享法则。
I want to wind up right now.
因此现在要做一个结论。
What does this mean to Taiwan?
这一些对台湾有什么意义吗？
We have been talking about the destiny of God for Taiwan.
我们一直在讲神对台湾的命定。
And we said it is God is the author of all nations.
我们说列国是神所造的。
God has got timing for different nations.
神对不同的国家也定下了他的年限。
And I want to speak to you as a messenger of the Lord.
现在我要以神的信差的身份来对各位说。
The timing of God for Taiwan is now.
神给台湾所定的时候就是现在了。
The timing of God for Taiwan is now.
神给台湾所预定的时刻就是此时。
Amen.
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 Yesterday I said to you.
昨天我跟各位说。
The season is changing.
季节在改变了。
The season is changing.
季节在改变了。
And over the last few years.
在过去这几年。
Do you realize what has been happening?
你明白发生了些什么事吗？
Spreading prayer.
祷告不断在扩展。
Every city.
在每一个城市里。
Every county.
每一县。
Building the momentum.
不断在建造祷告的动力。
And this year,
今年
as we gathered last year in November,
当去年十月我们聚集
in Chai,
在嘉义
the Lord said,
主说
now push for a momentum.
现在你一定要把这个动力推开。
That is why we made the program for this year.
所以我们就定下今年的计划。
We brought a team of missionaries from Uganda who spent here 6 months.
我们也从乌干达带来一支宣导团队
Going all over
在这里住了6个月在台湾的每一个城市
Calling up, let's raise the prayer level, let's raise the prayer level
呼唤百姓来提升祷告的层次
And it's been growing
所以不断在成长中
It's been rising in the different cities
在不同的城市里面祷告不断在增长
It's been rising in the different denominations
在不同的宗派里面祷告不断在增长
Oh, praise the Lord
是的，赞美主
Praise the Lord!
赞美主。
We've been getting reports and testimonies.
我们也不断听到一些报告跟一些见证。
Prayer is not only in the churches.
所以祷告已经不限于在教会内了。
It is going in the marketplace.
现在已经进到职场。
It's going among the youth.
而且在年轻人的族群里。
It's beginning to open up.
开始打开了。
If Taiwan is going to achieve its destiny,
如果台湾要成就它的命令
we have to open up Taiwan.
我们一定要让台湾敞开
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Then we said in November we shall come.
然后十一月我们说我们会来的
and work with at least four cities.
至少跟四个城市
to really bombard the heavens.
来做一个爆破的聚会。
We want to see thousands and thousands of people joining the prayer movement.
我们要看见数以千计的人加入这个祷告的运动。
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And I can say to you,
我可以这样跟各位说。
I believe the National Prayer Network is compiling a report.
我相信全国祷告网络现在
已经在集结这些资料。We saw thousands responding in Tainan.
在台南我们看到好几千的人起来回应
We saw thousands rising up in Kaohsiung
在高雄也好几千人起来回应
We saw thousands rising up in Hsinchu
在新竹也是几千人的回应
We saw leaders from different cities also come together
我们也看到从不同城市来的领袖聚集在一起
And as we conclude this campaign
当我们来结束这一次的这种苏醒聚会
I want to believe today
今天我这样相信
Here in Taipei,
在台北
that thousands will rise up and be counted among the army of the Lord.
数以千计的台北的百姓弟兄姊妹也要兴起加入耶和华的军队。
I want to believe that here,
我相信在这里
there are men and women who will rise up today.
今日弟兄姊妹们要兴起。
To say, I want to be trained.
说是的，我愿意接受训练。
I want to be equipped.
我要接受装备。
To take my position in the forces of the Lord.
在主的军队里面站定我的位置。
I want to go back to my family.
我要回到我的家。
I want to start cleansing my roots.
我要开始洁净我家族的根源。
We want to bring cleansing to the land.
所以我们要为这片土地带来洁净。
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I can say to you with all the confidence.
所以我满满的信心告诉各位。
I can say to you this with the confidence of a person who has walked through this before.
是一个走过这历程的人所带出来的信心，这样跟各位说。
That Taiwan is ready to start cleansing the land.
台湾已经预备好可以做洁净土地的工作了。
We are ready to start dealing with the roots of the nation.
我们可以开始来处理这个国家根源的问题了。
Remember what the Bible says about Jubilee.
记得圣经跟对这个禧年怎么教导吗？
Every man return to your family.
每一个人各回本家。
Every man go back to your people.
回到你的百姓当中。
And bring restoration.
来带来修复与重建。
Amen.
Amen.
I want to challenge you today.
所以今天我要挑战各位。
And I know there are many people who are new to this that we are sharing right now.
我知道我们今天所分享的这些，或许很多人觉得是新的信息。
I want to challenge you to say to the Lord today.
但是我要挑战你，今日对主说。
I want to join this prayer movement.
说主啊，我愿意加入这个祷告的运动。
Amen.
Amen.
I want to join this prayer movement.
我要加入这个祷告运动。
Amen.
And I want to be taught. I may not understand everything right now.
或许现在我不是明白每一件事。
But I want to be taught.
但是我愿意接受教导。
How to deal with the negative roots in my family.
怎么样去对付我家族里面这些负面的根。
In my job.
在我的工作里面。
I want to believe the pastors today.
今天我也愿意相信牧师们。
What happened here was wonderful before the sermon.
在讲道的时候所发生的这一切都很好。
I don't think that has ever been done in history of Taiwan on this particular ground.
我想在台湾的历史当中，在这片土地上面，今天所发生的事以前没有发生过。
I want to ask you to do one thing today.
所以牧师们，今天我要求你们做一件事。
You can lay claim upon this ground.
你可以再一次宣告得回这片土地。
As an altar of the Lord.
成为主的祭坛。
You can say to the Lord.
你可以对主说。
We dedicate this ground to you.
我们把这片土地献给你。
Let your presence remain here.
让你的同在留在这片土地上。
Many people will come and go.
人们来来去去。
But your presence will remain here.
但是你的同在永远留在这地。
Amen.
Amen.
And I want to say to the pastors here today.
今天我要对在座的牧师们说。
And I want to ask all of you men and women and children of God.
我也要问每一位神的儿女、
pastors, will you please,
弟兄姊妹们。
Will you please come up the platform?
牧者们，请你们上台。
We want to believe God.
我们要相信神。
That our spiritual leaders,
我们属灵的领袖们
do not only dedicate Taiwan to God,
不仅把台湾献给神
but they will covenant to each other,
而且他们也要彼此立约
to stand together,
要同心站立
to work together,
同心合意
across denominational barriers.
超越宗派的范围
across ethnic barriers
超越族群的范围
and work for the purposes of God in Taiwan
为神在台湾的目的而努力
there are 20 other sites that are watching this right now
现在还有20个其他的人也在观看这一刻
we want to come into a covenant with God
所以我们要一起与神立约
I cannot do this for you, I'm not from Taiwan
我不能够为各位做这件事因为我不是台湾人
But I'm here to be a witness
但是我在这里我要成为一个见证
And I say leaders
我说领袖们
Let it be done before your people
让这事成就在百姓们的面前
That you covenant yourselves to one another
你们彼此立约
To be each other's keeper
能够成为看守彼此的人
To love each other
彼此相爱
To work together
彼此努力
to work for the kingdom of God in Taiwan
为神在台湾的国而努力
to assure God's people
来向神的百姓确定
Taiwan shall rise up to its destiny
确定台湾必然要进入他的命定
Hallelujah
Amen.
Hallelujah
Hallelujah
And I want to beg you today
今天我也要感谢各位
I call heaven and earth to be the witnesses
天地为证
I ask you and I beg you in the name of Jesus
我奉耶稣的名祈求你们
that you will commit yourselves to the Lord
你愿意将自己委身于神
to lead the church in Taiwan
带领台湾的教会
in seeking God
来寻求神
to begin to seek the Lord
开始来寻求主
for the cleansing of Taiwan
为台湾的洁净来寻求主
for the healing of the wounds of Taiwan
为医治台湾伤害来寻求主
for the cleansing of the families of Taiwan
为洁净台湾众家族来寻求主
the cities of Taiwan
洁净台湾的城市
the nation of Taiwan
洁净台湾
we want to believe that God's favor will come down
我们要信神的恩宠必然降临
we want to dedicate the whole of next year to believe the cleansing and the healing of the Lord will begin to sweep across the nation
我们要相信接下来一整年神的洁净神的医治要开始横扫整个台湾
Hallelujah
Amen
Hallelujah
Amen
Father we give you praise we give you glory
父啊我们赞美你我们将荣耀归给你
Amen
You have even shown us a signOf your grace and mercy in the skies today.
今日，你甚至在天空中向我们显明你恩惠怜悯的记号。
So I pray to you, my Lord.
所以主啊，我对你祷告。
Let all heaven be witnesses today.
让诸天成为今日的见证。
As your leaders join hands and hearts together.
当你的领袖们手牵手心连心。
As Taipei joins all the other cities of Taiwan to lead the way.
当台北加入台湾其他的城市，一起来开创新局。
Let your favor come upon this land.
让你的恩宠临到这片土地。
Let your anointing come upon this land.
让你的恩膏倾倒在这片土地。
In Jesus' name.
奉耶稣的名。
In Jesus.
所有今天我们在这里的我们要 po 两张照片给大家看你们看到了吗你们看到了吗 有一片彩虹，如同一只老鹰，在我们中间，在我们头上，彩虹为证。这个时候，不只是为了台北，我诚挚的邀请在座所有的牧者们、牧师们、牧师们，请你到台前来。牧师、传道们、师母们，我们到前面来，天地为证，到前面来。师母、牧师、传道同工，请到前面，请到前面，我们要一起，我们要一起，要彼此立约。没有一个人靠着自己可以完成的，我们需要所有的传道同工，我们同负一个，我们同负一个，不管教会大小，不分性别宗派，我们只有一个命定，我们只有一个军队，我们只有一个意向。我想这张照片，你要说它像什么，你一看就知道它像什么了。所以今天台上台下，我们举起手，我们牵在一起，我们彼此立约好吗？我知道还有台南的牧师也来了，这个不是为了台北而已，这是为了全国，我们彼此立约在一起。无论你坐得多远，我拜托你到前面来，看到你的左右，告诉他说，我们一起立约奔前面的道路好吗？你让出路，让牧师出来之后，我们也牵在一起，跟你旁边的人说，少了你一个都不行。我们扬起身来祷告，